Yeah, God bless you, viewers, listeners, and brothers and sisters, wherever you're hooking up. I'm coming under the tone of my voice. God bless you. Yeshua. Yeshua. HaMashiach. El Shaddai. Yeshua. HaMashiach. El Shaddai Elohim, Yeshua HaMashiach, El Shaddai Elohim, Jehovah Sikendu, Alpha and Omega, Yeshua HaMashiach, El Shaddai Elohim, Alpha and Omega, Alpha Yeshua HaMashiach El Shaddai Elohim Alpha and Omega Alpha and Omega Alpha and Omega Alpha and Omega Alpha and Omega. Thank you for your deliverance. Thank you for delivering us. Thank you for breaking the curses. Thank you for pulling us away from our ancestral curses. Thank you, God, for redeeming us, God, from the curse and the time of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus, God, Father, for fighting the battle. Thank you for stopping the mouth of the witches and wizards and the powers of darkness. Thank you for connecting to our divine connection. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Brethren, thank you so much for coming to Warfare Room, where destiny, virtue and glory has been restored by Pastor Esther Idugo through intersection. God bless you, brethren. Whatever you're hooking up to on this platform, the Lord is going to reward you mightily. And apart from that, whatever testimony you're expecting, the Lord is going to give it to you. God bless you. Today again, we're going to still continue about the broken of curses through intersection. We're going to take very prophetic affirmative words today, and please tighten your seatbelt as you continue this ministration with me. God bless you. Father, we thank you because we've come here today. Thank you, Daddy, because you're such an awesome God, and I worship and adore your name. I thank you because your children go through this intercession today, an affirmation of your word, prophetic word, God. Father, we shall be delivered. Yokes will be broken, God. Deliverance, God, they shall be held, oh God. Sicknesses, hypertension, diabetes, all will be gone, oh God. Arthritis will be gone, oh God. Father, every schizophrenic, oh God, Father, mental ill health, oh God, shall be disappeared in Jesus' name. Father, I thank you because we hook up, oh God, Father, this platform with faith, because we know, God, Father, our deliverance is sure. Our divine connection, oh God, Father, we thank you because certainly, God, you're going to take us to another new level in Jesus' name. I pray that any scripture, any word that is going to be shared today, may you come through, oh God, Father, through the Holy Spirit, to go through your power and pull down those strongholds, to go to strong man and strong woman, oh God, Father, that are holding your children bound and breaking, oh God, Father, those curses, go through our ancestors, to go in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So pray, brethren, welcome. So last week we did talk about that. Was sorry a couple of weeks ago because we were in arm for last week, and we apologize for that. So we did spoke about some of those few points that guided us on how our causes can be broken. So we spoke intensely about abortion. We spoke about ancestral mortgage. We spoke about false witnesses. We spoke about lying. We spoke to us about every marine witchcraft, those things. We spoke about fornication and adultery, that those things that are actually bring curses, disobedience. And today again, sure, we are trying to sum it up, we're trying to round it up. We're asking the Lord to give us the understanding in Jesus' name. And what was the last week's scripture was taken from Psalm 11 verse 3. It says, when the foundation is destroyed, what can the righteous do? The tango for today. And of course, we typically took one of those character in the Bible, which is Jabez. And that was 1 Chronicles chapter 4 verse 9. And when Jabez actually realized what was going on, he fought his way through prayer, through warfare room, where his glory destiny were being restored through intercessory prayer. And of course, God, this warfare room for today is intercession that is broken our causes. You know, that is going to pull down stronger anything that is fighting against you. What is the opposite of blessing is cause? And so causes could come through pronouncements, through evil ritual intention against you. Causes could come through spoken word, through disobedience to parent. We pray that such things shall be broken totally and Christ shall redeem us out of it in Jesus' name. So today again, we're more of going to concentrate our intention to try how we're going to revoke and renounce and denounce those things, those causes that are against us. And first of all, the first legal step to take is to ask God for forgiveness. The moment you ask God for forgiveness and you repent of that sin, automatically God will step in now and start fighting your battle for you. So we're gonna not going to tarry much in preaching administration, but we're going to go straight into prophetic prayer affirmation, and where you're going to strategize yourself and say, Father, you have to come to my life today and pull down those trunks and break those curses through Numbers chapter 23 verse 23, but there 117, that upon man's end there should be deliverance, holiness will follow suit while possess our possession, and Galatians chapter 3 verse 13 and 14. And then of course through decree too in Job 22, that God Almighty, as he comes into our life, as we decree a thing, is being established, and that where one of the people are in his name, whatever thing we bound here on earth is bound in heaven. So brethren, what are the main scripture that we're going to be backing upon today? Colossians chapter 2 verse 14 and 15, and then we're going to be backing upon Proverbs chapter 8 verse 15, that said by wisdom is a king reign and princesses they decree thing. And so in the book of Esther 2, you know, when Haman actually finished writing whatever decree he was writing, it was a boomerang, whatever thing was writing against those children. So whatever thing that is being spoken against us today will be boomerang against our enemy in Jesus' name. So can you take this prayer affirmation with me, please? So Isaiah chapter 8 verse 8 and 10 say, and he shall pass through Judah, and he shall overflow and go over, and he shall reach even to the neck, and stretching out his wings, and shall fill the breadth and the land. He said, oh, Emmanuel, associate yourself. I'm taking it from King James Version. All ye people, he said, ye shall be broken into pieces, and give ye all ye for far countries. Guard yourself together. Ye shall be broken into pieces. He said, guard yourself together. Ye shall be broken into pieces. Now, he said, ye shall be broken into pieces. Take counsel together, and it shall not come to pass. In Jesus' name, speak the word, and it shall not stand, for God is with us. That's why the legal step you have to take, that you won't give any enemy any stronghold in your life, is to repent, renounce, and ask God for forgiveness. Totally go away from anything that give the enemy the legal round to inflict curses, and to make sure that such evil curses come to pass in our life. We're going to make sure we totally forbid them. Understand? So it says, take this affirmation prayer with me. It is going to be well with you. This week is going to be, you're going to be highly favored. The Lord is going to promote you. Key of success will be given to you. You'll be above your contemporaries. As you wake up to pray, say, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, the Lord is going to respect your word. He's going to bring exactly what you want. Rejection, spirit of hatred, oh God, resentment, anger will be cleansed away from you through the blood of Jesus Christ. The fire of the Holy Ghost will burn to ashes anything that is not right in your body in Jesus' name. Now, your prayer altar will be brandished with the Holy Ghost fire. Now from today henceforth, you'll be interceding tirelessly, because guess what? The Lord has given you power to do that. Anything you lay your hand upon shall be successful in the mighty name of Jesus. From today henceforth, there won't be sickness, diabetes, hypertension, any arthritis, any cause. Nothing shall come to pass. Nothing shall come to ruin you. The Lord said he's going to counsel them in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you for the promotion. Thank you for the favor. Thank you for the divine connection. Thank you for the anointing that break the yoke of Satan. Take this affirmative word with me. Say, Jesus Christ has purchase us. You know, say the Lord has given us freedom from every curse of the law. Say so. Say Jesus Christ has given us every freedom from every curse of the law in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. They say by the offering through Jesus Christ, God has to offer himself as a sacrificial lamb for you and I to be redeemed from the curse. Say, Christ has redeemed us from curse, because Christ was crucified upon the cross of Calvary. So now the curses that are laid upon you consciously and unconsciously, spoken through betrothed, so spoken through any means, God has taken it away, because Christ has paid the price upon the cross of Calvary in Jesus' name. Say, oh Lord, my Father. Say, because I'm a child of God, Say, because I'm the heir of Christ, say from today, because Christ advocates for me, say, as I lay my hand upon any of my business, say, they shall exalt. He said, there shall be promotion in the mighty name of Jesus. Say, in the name of Jesus Christ, say, has given us to exercise authority in different worlds. So as you speak, say, I bound you, I counsel you, I destroy you, because as Christ has given you the authority in, according to Matthew chapter 18, verse 18. He said, where one or two people are in my name, anything they agree upon, whatever thing they bound here on earth, it is bound in heaven in Jesus' name. Say, you take authority over the heavens, the earth, and the seas, and under the earth, and anything in them. You say, you destroy with the sword of the Lord, with the Spirit of God. Say, every darkness that is posing against you, that is standing against your way, against your progress, that God Almighty should set them ablaze in Jesus' name. Say, I shall make heaven, I will not die. I will live to decree the work of God. I shall make heaven, I will not die. I will live to decree the work of God in Jesus' name. Say, the blood of Jesus saved me from every wrath of God in Jesus' name. Say, oh Lord, my Father, have mercy upon me, O God. Remove every evil consequences of sin, O God, from my life in Jesus' name. He said, through the blood of Jesus, we'll receive forgiveness of our sin. Say it. Say, through the blood of Jesus, we'll receive the forgiveness of our sin in Jesus' name. Say, through the blood of Jesus, we'll become merciful in Jesus' name. Say, through the blood of Jesus, we'll become merciful in the mighty name of Jesus. Say, he is no longer, oh God, the Lord is not going to longer remember our past again in Jesus' name. Say, every accusation of Satan from today henceforth, God, we will turn around to success and blessing. Success and blessing. Success and blessing. Success and blessings in the mighty name of Jesus. Say, by the blood of Jesus, there's no condemnation for you and I in Jesus' name. Say, because we walk in the light and the blood of Jesus cleanses us from all sin in Jesus' name. Say, we confess that every ancestral dedication, you know, of us or to our family or our lineage to any idol, God, sacred water and tree be broken to pieces and set ablaze, broken to pieces and set ablaze. Say, we shall not suffer anything because Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law in the mighty name of Jesus. Say, by the power in the blood of Jesus, we decree that every curse of sexual immorality that has but passing on through lineage from one lineage to the other, resulting into incest, lesbianism, homosexuality, bestiality, except fornication and adultery that brought curse and abortion to also say, oh Lord, our Father, say, redeem us from such evil sexual curse in Jesus' name, go iniquity. And said, through our paternal and maternal shall be broken to pieces in Jesus' name. Say, for Jesus Christ bruised, O God, Father, our transgression on the cross of Calvary. Say, for the Father, they gave him the tetanus stripe. Isaiah 53 did say, he said, from today hence, for you and I are liberated. We are freed in Jesus' name. Say, every curse affecting our dwelling place, our position, our land, our property as a result of any past ritual sacrifices performed on us, say, be broken to pieces. Say, by the power in the blood of Jesus. Say, it is written, life and death are in the power of our tongue. Say, I confess today, I shall live. I shall be promoted. See, because they said life and death is the power of your tongue. Say, I bound every curse. I cancel them. I destroy them. Say, I shall exalt today. I shall be successful. I shall be worthy. I shall be knowledgeable. Say, confess. This is a prayer of affirmation in this warfare room where glory, destiny, and virtue is being restored. Typically, our distinctive character that we studied about was about Jacob in the past, if you know quite all right. And now this is Jabez. So you have to stand and say, because Christ said, he said, life and death is in your tongue, so you have the authority. Say, you will not see the evil men will not see you. Any people where rituals are going on, they won't see you in Jesus' name. Say, you should run, jump and pass in Jesus' name, jump and pass, jump and pass, jump and pass in Jesus' name. So when the evil are ahead of you, you'll be behind. When they are behind, you'll be ahead. They won't see you. They will not even come close to you in the mighty name of Jesus, both in the physical and the spiritual. Anyone that wants to steal anything from you in the spiritual, that God should wither their hand, they shall be paralyzed in Jesus' name. Have you ever experienced somebody who is paralyzed? Anyone that wants to touch you should be paralyzed in Jesus' name in your dream. Say, oh Lord, my Father, say from today henceforth, say I shall be attracting favor. Yes, attract favor. That all the promises of God shall come to you in Jesus' name. Okay? Say, because the Lord said, because I have power in my tongue. Say, from today henceforth, I shall go to example, I shall pass it. My children shall be successful. My husband shall be successful. My wife shall be successful. My ministry shall be successful. Nothing shall hinder and stop it. Though if the enemy comes in like a flood, according to Isaiah chapter 59, verse 19, shall lift up a standard. I shall finish paying all my debt in Jesus' name, okay? So you have the authority to do that. Say, every curse I've personally attracted to my life through every action of promises or vows, oaths or negative confession, be broken by the blood of Jesus Christ. So the scripture says, whatever I bound here on earth, it is bound in heaven. The Bible says, it says, where I was sold without any money, the Lord will buy me back in Jesus' name. That is Isaiah chapter 49, 23 to 26. Can a lawful captive be set free? He said, where you are sold without even money, cheaply, in through carelessness, through any evil covenant you went into. You know, you understand that God should buy you out in Jesus' name. Every cost resulting from any consultation with spirit, herbalists, oracles, mediums. It's a promise. I break you with the blood of Jesus. Lose your hold over our life in Jesus' name. Lose your hold over our life in Jesus' name. Lose your hold over our life in Jesus' name. Lose your hold over our life in Jesus' name. These are affirmative words. Prophetic affirmative words. Don't joke with it. So stand by it and declare it to yourself. Say, from the crown of my head to the sole of my feet, I am made whole in Jesus' name. I'm made whole. Say, every curse activated through my personal sin, be removed, you know, by the blood of Jesus. Say, I confess that I'm now in the service of God. He said, my body, my temple, as written, that God will dwell in me and walk by me. You understand? That God shall dwell in me richly. Say, the peace of the Lord abide with me in my compound, in my house, in my home. Okay? Say, you command that all the demons operating or causes to vacate your life now. Vacate by fire, vacate by fire. Out, 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 out. Vacate by fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Okay? Say, I shall be the head, I will not be the tail. In Jesus, I shall be blessed above my contemporaries. In the mighty name of Jesus. Say, my house shall be filled, oh God, Father, with blessings. In Jesus' name. Say, I reject every manipulation. Every manipulation. The moment you notice manipulation, start praying against it. It's not good. Say, I reject manipulation. I reject manipulation. I reject manipulation. I reject manipulation. In the mighty name of Jesus. Okay? So this affirmative word, they work, oh God. They work like a medication. Okay? So you pay attention to it. Say, oh Lord, my Father, the God, oh God, Father, that blesses Abraham, Isaac, oh God, that blesses, oh God, Father, Israel, bless me too. Let the blessing of Abraham, Moses, and Isaac, and Israel all be transferred to me in Jesus' name. They can be transferred to you if you are respecting the word of God. If you are not disobeying, they can be transferred to you. Okay? So those are the prophetic affirmative words I'm talking about. Say, I command all of those things, oh God, that from the north, west, southwest, and east, because God said there's power in my tongue, that let the wealth of the Gentiles be transferred to you in the mighty name of Jesus. Okay? So you are going to command those favor to meet you. Say, Father, I pray that the favor of God fall upon me, favor of God, fall upon me, favor of God, fall upon me, favor of God, fall upon me. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus, let the favor of God fall upon me. In Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 13. And the Lord says, shall make you the head, but not the tail, and you shall be above only in Jesus' name, and shall not be beneath. Say, if thou hearken unto the commandment of the Lord thy God, which he commanded this day to observe and to do them. In Proverbs chapter 21, verse 1, he said, the king's heart is in the hand of the Lord. As the river water it, so he turn it. He said, whatever he will do, whoever that causes, he said, the king's heart is in the hand of the Lord. Like you hand them over to God, okay? God bless them, but hand them over to God. It's a Proverbs chapter 11, verse 27, he said, he that did intently seeketh good procureth favor, but he that seeketh mischief, it shall come upon him. Now, because you have, because in this morning ministration, in James chapter 3, verse 10, he said, can curse and a blessing be coming from the same mouth? No. The obligation of God for us, he says, is that we shall fulfill all his calling here on earth. So I pray that you shall concentrate and know exactly what to do and how you are going to pull down the strongholds and all those, the kingdom of Satan, through your discretion and wisdom, in Jesus' name of God. You understand? He said, Jeremiah chapter 32, verse 20, he said, behold, I am the Lord, the God of all flesh. Is there anything too hard for God to do? Have you ever seen anything too hard for God? The one that built all the plateaus of earth, the one that brought the mountain, the sea, the one that created the heaven and earth. What is so difficult for God to do that he will not do in your life? So, brethren, you are going to affirm this one with me. Say, it is well with you. I am blessed. I am highly favored. I shall overcome. I shall be blessed. I'm called beautiful. I'm called handsome. Say, a difficulty I roll away. Every part of darkness are away. Father, the Holy Ghost will cleanse me and wash me from the crown of my head to the sole of my feet in Jesus' name. Say, I shall travel to places. I shall minister the word of God. People will not go to hellfire through me. Abomination. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, God. Say, I shall, wherever I go, he said, I will be dining in the midst of the kings and the prince in Jesus' name of God. That is what it is. So you affirm those positive things to your life. Say, my mind, say, Holy Ghost fire, possess it, possess it, possess it, possess it, possess it, my mind, Holy Ghost fire, possess it in Jesus' name. Say, I will not let my mind that the enemy shall tread on it in Jesus' name. No, refute it, okay? Refute it. You see, in Daniel chapter 1, verse 9, he said, now God had brought Daniel into favor and tender love with what? The prince of the eunuchs. So that's why you have to say, Father, I will be rich. I shall be wealthy. I shall dine with the kings and the queens. Okay? Nothing less than that. In Jesus' name. Say, Sister Esther, but look at my situation. No. The Lord is going to promote you and take you out of those dungeons, out of that ghetto, in the mighty name of Jesus. He's going to bless you abundantly. Okay? So it is well with you. It is well with your family. From today, henceforth, God, isolation of peace, spirit shall be with you in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord shall be with you mightily. Okay? God bless you. So you quickly going to take this scripture down. Say, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, you deal with ancestral covenants and causes by using Exodus chapter 20, verse 1 to 5 and Zechariah chapter 7, verse 14. Okay. Say, to heal the land of the causes and pollution and defilements in Genesis chapter 3, verse 17, Leviticus chapter 18, verse 24 and Zechariah chapter 7, verse 4. Okay. Say, oh Lord, my Father, surround me, fortify me with your wall of fire. So, oh Lord, my Father, surround me and fortify me with your wall of fire. Oh Lord, my Father, surround me and fortify me with your wall of fire. Oh Lord, my fire, surround me and fortify me with your wall of fire. Oh Lord, my Father, surround me and fortify me with your wall of fire. Oh Lord, my fire, surround me and fortify me with your wall of fire. Father, thank you for the deliverance of these ones online. Thank you so much, God, for that. Any difficulty, any kind of pain they're going through, any kind of hardship, God, any kind of disgrace and report that any miracle bring today henceforth, God, it has been totally cleansed. From today, they will come out with testimony. They shall testify of the goodness of the Lord all the days of their life in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, because you're such an awesome God. Thank you because you've removed all those difficulties they are facing. Thank you for removing the sickness. Thank you, oh God, Father, for the perfection. Thank you so much because you despise your ministering angel to visit each one of them, oh God, in their homes. Father, consecrate the environment. We cover this podium with the blood of Jesus Christ. Father, as they go to their bed, as they anoint themselves, oh God, the anointing that breaks the yoke of Satan in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, merciful Father, because you're good. In Jesus' name we pray. Yeshua HaMashiach Lebroko Satia. Yeshua HaMashiach. Yeshua HaMashiach HaMashiach. Yeshua, Yeshua HaMashiach. Jehovah Rapha, Yeshua HaMashiach. Yeshua HaMashiach, Yeshua HaMashiach, Yeshua HaMashiach. Thank you for healing, darling. Thank you for removing the fever. Thank you for removing the difficulty. Thank you, God, Father, for bringing laborers into your field, God, because you say the harvest is ripe, but the laborers are few. The Lord say, if you are not ready for him to use you, he has about fresh prophets out there who has not bowed their head to the idol yet, and oh God, who has not defiled themselves. So get yourself ready to work for the Lord, because there's a reward. Thank you, Father, for guiding our heart. Every fiery dart, so God, for removing them, because we hold the shield of faith. We hold the shield of faith. Thank you, Jesus, God, for those affirmative words, God, these ones are using, God, for themselves, God, before they go to bed, God. Father, they shall see God. They shall see good dreams, God. Father, you shall remove, God, remove every power of darkness, God. Remove any anxiety, worriness, God, away from their life in Jesus' name. Thank you for the divine connection. Thank you for the promotion. Thank you, God, Father, for certainly we shall praise and testify of the goodness of the Lord all the days of our life. In the mighty name of Jesus, I cover them specially with the fire and the blood of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen and amen. God bless you and stay blessed.